Hello, dear students. Let's see logical operators which are used for building or constructing complex conditions. Now, there are three logical operators and, as you see, double ampersand symbol. Then this double pipe or the vertical line is called OR. This double ampersand is and there is one more exclamation symbol which is NOT. These three are logical operators. Now have a look at AND operator definition. Basically, whenever you use AND operator, what you are doing is you are actually joining two different conditions. So you have got two different conditions and operator joins the two conditions in such a way that the entire condition will become true only if both the conditions are true. Let's see what I am talking about. Let's say we have two conditions, C1 and C2. For some time, you know, we will not go for actual conditions, but let's say C1 and C2 are two conditions. Like this, C1 can be anything, like A greater than B, some condition you imagine. Okay. So we have two conditions, C1 and C2, and we have ANDed them. These two conditions have been ANDed with AND operator. Now this entire thing, C1 and C2, becomes a single condition such that this entire condition will become true only if C1 is true and C2 is true. If both C1 and C2 are true, only then this entire condition will be true. It is just like AND logic gate, where the output is high only if both the inputs are high, otherwise the output is low. So the second type of operator is OR. Now, OR is a logical operator which also joins two conditions. As you see, C1 is one condition, OR C2 is other. Now, this entire thing becomes one condition now because OR has joined these two conditions. And this entire condition will be true if at least one of the conditions is true. Just check. At least one of the conditions need to be true. So suppose C1 is true, but C2 is false. But we have written OR. So as C1 is true, the entire condition will be treated as true. Otherwise, let's say C2 is true, but C1 is false. Still the condition will be true. And what if both conditions are true? Then it is well and good. OR is joining two true conditions, then the net result will be true. But what if both are false? If both are false, then the condition will become false. This is exactly like the OR gate, isn't it? Where the output is high if at least one of the input is high. Okay. Similarly, there is something called NOT operator. Now, NOT is just used for negating a condition. It's a unary operator. Just check. Why? Because NOT operates only on one condition. You can see that AND is a binary operator. It's a binary operator because it works on two different conditions and joins these two conditions. Similarly, OR is also a binary operator because it joins two conditions. Whereas NOT is a unary operator. It works only with one condition. What it does is that if this condition is true, suppose, then the entire condition becomes false because NOT of true is false. Okay. And what if this condition C1 is false? Then this entire condition becomes true because NOT of false is true. So it is just meant for negating a condition. We use this condition number of times. For example, as a simple example, we have got a file and we want to read that file till end of file is not reached. So we typically write something like while if not EOF FEOF of FP, where FP is a file pointer. Forget about this. I just wanted to show that this NOT is saying that if end of file is not reached, only then perform the job. Something of that sort, where not negates the condition. Let's see an example. Here we are going to use AND operator for joining two conditions. We are asked to write a program to find largest between three integers. Don't take this program lightly, because this program is wrong. Just an announcement I am making. This program is wrong. What we are supposed to do is declare three integers A, B, C, ask the user to input three integers. Let's say user inputs the three integers as 3, 6, 2. Then my program should find out who is the largest, which is the largest value, and it should print that largest value. So 6 should be printed in this example. It is very easy to think of how will you check largest between three values. You will ask, is A greater than both B and C? So that's what we have done here. If A is greater than B and A is greater than C, both are true, then obviously A is largest. So we will print A. Because A is largest, we are printing A. But what if this is false? So we will go to else and we will ask another question. Okay, A is not largest, but then is B largest? So we'll ask, is B greater than A and B greater than C? Is B greater than both A and C? If it is true, then we'll print B. But what if this is also false? You see, A is not largest, B is not largest. So when we land in the last else, we have nothing to choose now. Obviously, C should be largest and we will print C. So as in our example goes, we had taken the three values as 3, 6 and 2. Just ask the first if, is 3 greater than 6? False. This first condition itself is false. As 3 greater than 6 is false. Please don't waste time in checking the other condition. What's the sense? Because you are using and if one condition is false, then how is the condition going to become true ever? It will be always false if the one condition is false. So this if is false, so we will land in the else. We are now asking, is B, which is 6, greater than 3? And is B, which is 6, greater than 2, which both are true, you notice. So we are printing B and the value of B is 6. As B is printed, the last else won't run and that's it. The program will end. So what's wrong in this? You remember I said that there is something wrong here. What if you give two values equal? Let's say 6, 6 and 2. And our program should print largest number. So largest number is 6. Come on. Even if 6 is repeated twice, but 6 is largest, so it should print 6. You know what the program will print? I hope you have found out, gate students. I hope you have found out. This program will print 2. 2 is largest. Let's see how. First if is checked. You ask, is 6 greater than 6? Note, A is 6, B is 6. 6 greater than 6 is false. And then forget it, we have used AND. If you have used AND, how come the condition can become true? Because one of the conditions is false. So we land in else. We then ask, is 6 greater than 6? Note, B and A both are 6. This is also false. And finally, we land in else. And once we are in this else, there is nothing that we are checking. And we are simply printing C. And C printed is 2. Which is wrong. Largest is 6. Isn't it? So what's wrong here? What went wrong, you know, is that we did not anticipate for the equal values. But you remember, we have an operator greater than or equal. In the place of all greater than, we can use greater than or equal to everywhere and the problem is solved. Actually, the topic was about AND. Sorry, topic was about AND. But I thought that I can tell you something about running the program on paper and checking that how the program is wrong for some inputs. Now come to the point. If A is 6, B is 6 and C is 2. Will this program print 6? Definitely. Because the first if is checking is 6 greater than or equal to 6, which is true. At least it's not greater, but it is at least equal. And then the second condition is checking is 6 greater than or equal to 2, because C is 2. Both are true, So AND operates to true and it prints A, which is 6. As A is printed, rest of the else is dropped and the program ends. You can try this with all values equal. Still it will work, and it works with distinct values also. So be careful to compare for the largest between three numbers with greater than or equal to operator, not with only greater than operator. Okay, more such programs and exercises will be done in the rest of the videos. Thank you very much.